Today in our series on self-esteem, we talk about an interesting form of treatment that is gaining the interest of many people. If you stick around, you won't be disappointed.
PanicAttackRecovery.com.
Hi, I'm Lynette from PanicAttackRecovery.com. We're a collaboration of former sufferers helping people with panic attacks, stress, anxiety, depression, and ADHD. Welcome back to our series on self-esteem. Today, we want to discuss a psychological treatment called EMDR. The abbreviation EMDR stands for Eye Movement Desensitization and Reprocessing. EMDR was developed by psychologist Francine Shapiro in 1987. Research on and use of this method has continued to grow, making EMDR a popular technique in treating mental health disorders. It was initially used to treat post-traumatic stress disorder, PTSD. Recently, EMDR has become a more common treatment option for anxiety and panic disorder. It might be something to consider if you find other treatments such as cognitive behavioral therapy are not as effective as you'd like them to be. This type of treatment has been reported to some professionals to be helpful for people who prefer a treatment that doesn't require as much talking like forms of psychotherapy do. And because of this, some children and adolescents can find it appealing. EMDR works by a therapist having you follow the therapist's hands with your eyes as their hands move back and forth from side to side. This type of pattern of movement is thought to be linked to the same movement of your eyes when you're in REM sleep. It's thought that when you're in REM sleep, your mind is able to process a whole number of daily events, some important events, and some seemingly trivial events. REM sleep is often when people dream the most, and it's thought that we consolidate memories during REM sleep. This is why dreams, at times, might seem to involve things that we might not even have thought about during the day, or even noticed. It's thought that the type of processing that occurs when the eyes move in this fashion can help to process events in our minds. In the case of trauma, it can help to resolve the trauma. In the case of issues that are related to anxiety and panic disorder, it could be an opportunity to process issues related to your anxiety and panic. These issues can also be related to your self-esteem. By providing a chance in session to work on these matters, it can resolve self-esteem issues over time. The movement in EMDR is referred to as bilateral stimulation. And there are a number of ways a therapist might cause this stimulation, such as tapping on your left knee and then your right knee, or giving you headphones or having you watch a simulation on a screen. All of these different ways to simulate the back and forth movement that occurs with the eyes during REM sleep. Now, there is more to an EMDR than just bilateral stimulation. There are actually 8 phases in the treatment. Not everyone is in agreement with using EMDR, so it's something that you should discuss with a mental health professional. If it is something you're interested in exploring, there are some in our community who feel that it has worked really well for them, and we wanted to share it with you. We hope that you've enjoyed this latest video and look forward to presenting a new video in the series next week. To make sure that you don't miss out on any of our content, please click on the card on the upper right corner of this video and subscribe to our free newsletter.